60 mile passages, left really quick, only doing a quick log. Just planned a passage to Cherbourg, and we're currently crossing the channel now. It seems like this week is going to be pretty hardcore. It's going to be go, 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 get the passages out. It's going to be comfortable. Got Tony again, so hoping some of it will be enjoyable. Signing off. Cherbourg, passage is going quite well, very flat, very light wind. Been downstairs doing that almost the whole time, just getting little naps here and there, skipping because I'm out of the watch rotation system, so I can just come up whenever I'm needed. Two up in a forced one. I just spent all day down just here at the nav desk, so I got a bit seasick. Just fantastic. I'm getting quite good at just going now though, throwing up in the middle, like, alright, let's crack on. That's all I can think of. You can just see the plan here. My courses to steer and my hourly updates, as you can see the tide has done us in an S shape as it's come around, and I've done a new one just for the approach here. Here right now, which is about 15 miles off, so we're looking to be in Cherbourg in the next 3 hour tops, then turn around and come back. Hopefully a successful passage. We'll keep you updated. I've literally just arrived, going to come in through the first entrance, come across at 220 degrees, and then come in and get quite close to the military base through the second entrance, and then you'll see the two leading red lights bring you into the harbour. It took a while to actually see them, so it's really good to see that. I completed my passage, we got here in one piece, 15 minutes later than the predicted time, the ETA, which isn't too bad.
Day two. I've just woken up from my sleep, I had 6 hours off, I finished my passage at 4 in the morning, it was, well, it's 20 to 10, I feel like I'm up to 10, I'm going to cook some breakfast. Passage was okay last night, as a skipper I stayed up for most of it, I was definitely up every hour, it was a bit longer. It looks like a beautiful day outside, you can't see it very well. Today we're heading to Weymouth.
What a lovely day, what a lovely day it is.
There is just sea all around us right now, which is sort of what you're going for in a boat. Panoramic. So boys.
We arrived at Weymouth, we had dinner here. I cooked up a prawn noodle dish, you know, with soy sauce and honey as the sauces, and that seemed to have run down quite well. We've got to get up real early. Let's do Jake's passage to Chichester tomorrow, because we'll be moving by 3.
3.32 on the 18th of December. We've just left Weymouth, there's a bit of footage, Jake is skippering it. Excellent. I think that's everything. I'm going to catch some shut-eye before my shift. Signing off. The watch system's working, I'm sleeping in the fore cabin. He's taking us both on watch, which I'm skippering the catch. So I'm sleeping in the fore cabin. I think there's a suspicious drip up there. Yeah, that's it. Into the Isle of Wight at the moment. That's the Needles over there. You can barely see them. We've got a huge amount of fog. Hear that beeping noise? That's the foghorn from Needles Lighthouse. Very cool.
Yeah, I've just come off watch. Started at 6 a.m. I've just finished and it's 10. And we're in the Solent. We came through Needles. I tried to get a little bit of footage of the fog. It is extremely foggy out there. Like, we can't see more than a mile in front of the boat, which is quite interesting. I actually heard the fog signals from the Needles. We're going into Cowes to refuel, because we used up almost all our fuel. There's fuel, there's no wind. And we're going to pick up some pots and pans so we can cook a Christmas dinner. So yeah, that's about it. And then we're going to go to Chichester and then back to Cherbourg. So I hope that I don't chuck my guts up again. The 4-on-4 system is a little bit wearing. I am so much happier to be doing it on this boat than I was on the Fardo. It's just, you know, everything's calmer. It's just our crew. And Tony keeps us all, you know, chilled out. Well, chilled out enough, but not too much. you start to imagine things in the fog, like just little things here and there. So yeah, I'm going to go and I'm going to get some sleep now. Signing off.
Say cheese.
Getting in the Christmas mood on the Marlville the trip. He's just left, Jake completed his passage to Chichester. Heading to Cherbourg now, I'm on this passage. Quite foggy. Let's do a little panoramic, so. Christmas tunes to cheer us all up.
Oh, what's going to be next?
What is going to be next? It's quite apt music at the moment. In the bleak midwinter. It is fairly cold, I'm not going to lie. How are you feeling, Chris?
Chilly.
Oh, I can't think of much to say. Really good passage to Chichester. It's good, Tony's quite happy. Fast asleep. There's Tony's asleep, Molly's asleep, Jake's asleep, everyone's asleep. Just me and Chris ploughing on through what is actually only 4 o'clock. We don't mind, because we've got our Christmas tunes on. Found out today, actually, you can use the mast as an antenna. Lesson learned there. This is on the Christmas playlist.
Do you want to build a snowman? Or ride a bike around the mall?
According to now, that's what I call music. This is Christmas.
This is Christmas.
Fucking Frozen.
I love Frozen.
Nothing on the Little Mermaid.
It is possibly my
favourite. It has
favorite.
Nothing on the Little Mermaid.
It is possibly my favourite Disney.
Under the sea.
Under the sea. Now it's winter, visibility is dropping rapidly. Christmas tunes continue. The horizon has disappeared, but the music goes on. There you go, we've just arrived in Cherbourg. 3 in the morning, just finished the passage. We've been going, we've just done 4 passages in 2 days. It's nuts. But yeah, have a look around. I'll do a panoramic. You won't be able to see much of Cherbourg City. The Port City. There's some very old and depressing buildings around us that look a bit Chernobyl-esque, we were saying on the way in. A lovely sleep, and then we've got a day in Cherbourg tomorrow. So, very excited for that. Otherwise, it was a good watch, it was a good passage, calm. Water is flat, I've never seen the channel as flat as that. It's just like a mill pond, literally, like no wind, nothing. And there was some gorgeous stars at one point. It was lovely. Anyway, that is it. Signing off. This is Cherbourg in the morning. There are palm trees here. See, it looks very industrial. That's our boat down there. Absolutely massive, colossal, really big port. Much more refreshed and ready for the day. I think everyone wants to sort of do their own thing. I'm getting the impression that's going to happen. I don't really have any money, so I'm sort of thinking maybe pack a packed lunch and go and head into Cherbourg and see what the city's all about. See if anything. Good's going on. Showers are all right here. Not exceptionally good. We're coming up to the end of a day in Cherbourg. I didn't do much, just had a wander around. Caught up in a little bit of sleep while we're here. Just left Cherbourg, heading to Weymouth. We love these early mornings. We've just left at 4 a.m, up at 3:30, to head to Weymouth. Brilliant. Looking to get there in sort of early afternoon. Which is 12 hours, and then we beat that to 4 in the afternoon. I love passages. No, it's alright, I'm pretty excited. Signing off.
headway there. Ah, living on a prayer, take my hand, we'll make it, I swear. Oh, living on a prayer. He's on the knees, and he used to make it tough, so tough.
Say hi, man. That man's the love of my life. One day I will have him.
Yeah, absolutely.
She didn't put a ring on. If you like a bit. Singing about Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry.
Getting close to Portlandville, Weymouth again. Made really, really, really good time on this passage. Looking to be there at about 2:30, 3 o'clock. Night in Weymouth, back on the for the crack of dawn tomorrow. Nail it, and then we're done for Christmas. Woo! Yeah. Well, we've got the music on, so we're just going. Peaceful lunch, well, a bit of mood lifter. Conditions have been light and rime or something, but yeah, they've been no wind at all. Pastures have been knocked out. We'll have six by the end of this. Okay, that's everything to me. Finally.
From Cherbourg to Weymouth today. We did it in record time though. We've got just done my passage plan for tomorrow. I'm the skipper again. We're going to Chichester. We're not actually going to go in, but we're going to go around the West Pole. So. Plan. So this is coming out of Weymouth here. All the way to St Albans Head, from St Albans Point down here, up to the Isle of Wight, into the Isle of Wight, across the Isle of Wight, all the way to Chichester, then the passage into Chichester here, the passage into Chichester Marina. So that's my old plan. I would recommend getting it. I've used a China graph pencil with which to do it, which means I can write on the plastic that the Chancellor Captain, which skippers love. Just get yourself one of these. Hashtag yay. And you know what's brilliant is just rub straight out. Brilliant.
Everybody's having fun. Look to the future now. It's only just begun.
Bad luck with Tone.
Oh, God, really? I'm going
to miss you, buddy.
No, of course you are, then.
Happy
Christmas. Take your tongue out, mate.
So we've just come back. Just come into the Solent. We got battered by wind and weather. And now we're back. Okay, now, we've got 11 winds up our arse, 11 knots up our arse. So we'll go into the Medina. And then we will drop the sail. Chris is cooking a Christmas dinner on a Sunsail boat.
It's got to be done.
A feat that has possibly never been achieved before by man. Interesting to see how it goes. It smells incredible right now. I believe this is, he's almost there now. Getting the hard parts out of the way. Very much looking forward to devouring it.
Cooking without burning yourself.
Have you burnt yourself yet?
About 8 times.
Just to let you know, this is the space. Like most people would have an entire kitchen for a Christmas meal, and this is the space that he has.
Look how loaded the fridge is.
Look at that. Look at that. Ridiculous. 3 trays in there. And have a lovely Christmas dinner, and then we are going home. Proper home.
Home time, baby.
Exactly. We're all very happy about that.
One quick one.
Oh, hello.
Happy anniversary, Luce.
Yeah, she won't see that for the anniversary because it's going to take like a month to write it.
Exactly. But now I won't get a bollock in and I'm still in the good boy book.
There you go. She is lucky. Look, that is a man. That is a proper man. He can cook, he can clean.
Very tough.
What happened? The oven broke today. That broke. Gas went off. What else happened? We got battered by wind and waves. The passage went a little bit skewy. Still arrived on time though, but abandoned the overall passage. And I'm pretty happy about that anyway. That's all I can think of. Very much looking forward to eating. Starving. No tea, no food, most of the day. Signing off. Mate. Well done, Chris. I want to say thank you, Chris.
Chris.
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Home. It's time. We're very, very ready. We're waiting for the chorus. I'll cut it so it works quite well. Just landed in Southampton.
Oh,
my wallet. Sorry about that. The storage capabilities of a Volkswagen Golf are Polo are unbelievable. For Christmas, signing off.